So what we're seeing is a completely different type of demand for ICU beds and ventilators than we've ever seen before. The surges that we're used to are maybe things like a small surge because of influenza or trauma patients coming in where suddenly we need a few extra beds or ventilators, but nothing like we're seeing in some areas. We're seeing people doing everything essentially that we can do. One is generating more ventilators, right? There's a lot of work going on just to literally increase the number we have. We are probably undervaluing the importance of nurses, doctors, respiratory therapists with true expertise in taking care of those patients. Patients will do better the more of those people we can keep healthy. And that really means an emphasis on personal protective equipment that is appropriate to really maintain that workforce to be healthy. Another piece that you're seeing play out differently across the world that I think is important is the idea of viewing ICUs and ICU beds as part of a more regional or larger system. And I think the worst thing we can do is siloed care. This idea that because a patient gets admitted to one hospital, it doesn't matter if they've got five free beds or they're overloaded with 100 extra patients, they're not going to be moved or the appropriate resources are not going to be brought into them. I think, in fact, the bigger concern is not places like Italy and the UK and the United States, but is places like areas in Africa where there truly are no ventilators. And so anybody who develops the degree of respiratory failure that's being seen in COVID is really not going to have that opportunity to be on a ventilator. And that's something that has always been the case, unfortunately, but now is going to be magnified by a very specific disease that manifests by the need for mechanical ventilation. You can't keep, 100,000 ICU beds empty for the next pandemic. You can't keep the workforce employed and paid waiting for patients to show up in the next pandemic. So there will be a balance between having plans in place, having stockpiles ready that are up to date. And I think the biggest piece has been the learning actually around personal protective equipment, which is something that is a bit easier to stockpile and keep ready for use than a lot of other things like people and beds. And so those are the things that I think can be focused on for the next round